Welcome to Between Heaven and Earth, an internet radio talk show where we help you connect spirit and divine guidance. Lisa Kay, your host, brings you shows that can enhance and transform your life with tips and new ideas for more happiness, abundance, and better relationships. Lisa is an expert on intuition and can show you how to strengthen your inner guidance to empower yourself. Each show is positive and uplifting to inspire your day. Her guest speakers are specialists on self-help, positive thinking, spirituality, and conscious living. Be the best that you can be with Between Heaven and Earth, conscious living for your soul.
Hey there, it's Lisa Kay, and we're back for another episode of Between Heaven and Earth Radio. And today, our show is called Coming Out, Revealing Our Intuition to Others. I hear this over and over again. I used to be very intuitive, and now I seem to have lost touch with it. People tell me that all the time, that they used to be very intuitive when they were very young, and something happened, and as they became an adult, they lost it. Now, I used to be a very sensitive person. Actually, I still am a sensitive person, but I'm not nearly as sensitive as I was when I was a little girl. When I was very little, everything hurt me. A careless word, an insensitive look, perhaps some attention abruptly shut off in favor of a more valued friend. And what made it worse was I was very, very quiet. My first grade teacher put in my report card, quote, "I wish she would speak up more." Now, growing up in a culture where being vocal and speaking up and sometimes speaking over each other was not only expected, but almost required for survival, I had to change. I think most sensitive, quiet people are very in tune with their intuition, but like me, they probably have pushed their sensitivity underneath and with it, their intuitive messages. If you were a highly intuitive as a child, you might have been ridiculed for being intuitive, or worse, threatened, or told your intuition insights were evil. I never got that far. I was too shy. I think what we do is we protect ourselves from being deeply hurt, so we withdraw. We cut it off. We try to build a thick skin so that we shut our sensitivity off. And our sensitivity is the part of us that told us intuitively all kinds of things about other people. I think that we mold ourselves into the person that we become when we're very young. And that's all influence from our childhood, from our vulnerabilities, from people saying things to us that have hurt us, from our hiding, from trying to protect ourselves, and that self is who we really are. But once we get to be an adult, you know, we still keep that part of us. We still have that part of us that we've covered up. It's still there. We forget who we were before we covered it up, but before we decided that, quote, "Oh, I can't show that real me," because it's what gets hurt. It's very vulnerable. But you know, it's still there, and every now and then it peeks out, and I think it comes out in our passions. It comes out when we do what we love, and it's available to us, but we cover it up. And I think what's even worse is we don't even recognize it. We don't see it anymore. We don't even know that we're doing it. Eventually, it's routine. You go through the world like I went through the world being more of a man, because I was in a man's world. I did science, I did engineering, and that was all a man's world. I had to lower my voice, and I spoke with more confidence. I hid the quieter, softer me, and I think a lot of us do that. But I think it's really important to share with the world who we really are. Now, how you share it and when you share it is a different thing. And granted that the world around us, sometimes they can take the truth and sometimes they can't. But I think what's probably even more important is that we share with ourselves who we really are. And if you find, like myself, that you covered up so much that maybe you're not showing people, you know, parts of you that are vulnerable, that are totally okay, even if it is vulnerable, then you have to look at that and try to come to terms with it. And that's what I'm doing, actually. I noticed in what I'm doing now in my work is looking at myself and wanting to share me with you. And like, who am I? What is it that I am? And what have I covered up over the years to become someone else because I didn't want to get hurt? And I'm all grown up now, so those things won't hurt me anymore, but I still may cover them up. And I think for all of us, vulnerability is a tough thing. We don't want to get hurt. We want to show what we feel is safe. But you know what? We're all vulnerable. We all experience similar and same things. And when we share that with each other, we see that, hey, you know, we're all human. We're all the same. And I think that's important. And I think by the same token, when you go back to that person, that little girl, that little boy that you were when you were young, that's where also your sensitivities lie. And that's where your connection to picking things up intuitively is stronger. And it's because we're open. We're open to ourselves. We're open to things around us and our own inner self. So that's why we have to share with ourselves who we really are and who we were. Now, it's interesting how the world looks at all of this. You know, we still have that concern, and there's a way to deal with that. I read in a study of 1,300 high-level business managers around the world that only 78% of them admitted that they regularly use their intuition to make big business decisions, but only 50% would ever publicly admit that they do so. Aha. It only seems that some of these hugely successful business people admit to using their intuition. They feel, well, they're not afraid, and maybe they made it, so who, you know, they probably don't care what other people think. You know, people like Richard Branson and Jeff Bezos and Oprah and Steve Jobs. Now, even the scientific world hides proof of intuition and its power. There's a mountain of scientific studies that have proven all kinds of intuitive abilities in humans that exist, but much of it is shunned by the scientific community. So why is it such a big secret? I think it's because of social stigma around intuition that comes from not being able to explain it. At least not in a concrete way that people can go, oh, I get it, A plus B equals C. But, you know, I believe in terms of intuition that whatever it is, if we can train our intuition skill to be reliable and useful, then it doesn't matter where it comes from. I like to believe it's a real way of receiving information that our thinking mind cannot access. And again, where it comes from, I like to believe, hey, I love magic too. And it seems like magic, and who knows where it comes from. It's okay. Wherever it comes from, it's fine. I have had so many people who come to my lectures or classes who are doctors and lawyers, engineers, teachers, scientists, software engineers, who didn't want anybody to know that they were learning about intuition. So what if you're one of them? Do you come out of the closet? If you are making decisions with your intuition, or you want to, and you have been or want to be successful in using your intuition, do you let people know? You know, you don't have to tell people exactly what's going on in your head when you make a decision. I mean, that's your private space, right? And what about those of you who are learning how to develop your intuition? What do you do? Well, when I was first seeking out ways to learn about intuition, I had to really dig. I didn't want to go down that woo-woo route. That really wasn't me. But, you know, sometimes there wasn't an alternative. And being open, I tried whatever I could to really understand what this phenomena was all about. And fortunately for me, I was able to figure out what it was and how to make it make sense to me. But I still didn't have people like myself who I could relate to when I was learning. You know, it was kind of lonely. And, you know, I didn't really find other people like me until they found me after I started teaching. And that's actually part of the reason why I started not only teaching about intuition, but also building a community of like minds. People like me, who are my students in my intuition development circle. And it's a great community that makes me very happy. So what does this all mean for people who are super interested in intuition but are afraid to, quote, come out? Well, here are a few things. Number one, if you're super sensitive but you buried your intuition, you're still intuitive. You just have forgotten about it. You haven't lost it. You've forgotten what it's like when those intuition messages have come through. And also because you've never really learned how to work with your intuition. It was just something that was hidden or popped up and it surprised you. It seems like a mystery now on how to get control over it. And never having learned about it, you never really learned how to control it. So don't worry, it's still there. You're still intuitive. It's just now that we've buried it with all these layers. And you can get it back. Number two, if you've never been intuitive but have a deep desire to learn how to be intuitive, like me, but you're afraid of other people knowing, you can find like minds in a group online, and no one needs to know you're there. That's the wonderful thing about technology. I love, love, love technology. And I often have people who are in our groups who say, oh, you know, nobody knows I'm doing this. And that's okay. Number three, everyone is intuitive. It's part of our biology. And I wish this is something, maybe this is the message for the masses and for my mission, is intuition is part of us. It's part of our biology. It's actually what all these people were talking about. Oh, I got my intuition. My intuition told it to me this way. Is really the way a particular part of our brain works and how it processes information. And if you understand that, you understand that it's part of you and everybody has it because we all have brains. And that's how we're meant to be. Just like animals have instinct, we have intuition and we're animals too. So don't worry if you're super sensitive, but you feel like you buried your intuition, you don't have contact with it, it's still there. You can still access it. Number two, if you're afraid of being, quote, found out of your interest, you can learn without being, quote, exposed. And number three, if you're wondering whether you could be intuitive, everybody can, because it's part of our biology. So we started this podcast with, you know, should I come out and reveal my intuition to other people? And if you're afraid of what other people are going to say, you don't have to tell people. And if you do, take the words from Andy Grammer. I just heard this today. I loved it. He said, if cynicism comes at you, don't ever turn down your shine. So don't let it get you down. Don't let it say something about you, what other people are thinking or what they're saying, their cynicism. No one knows what's going on in your head. That's your private space. If you want to access that intuitive information, it's all there. You just have to learn how to do it. I'm Lisa Kay, and you've been listening to Between Heaven and Earth Radio. If you want to learn more about your intuition, you can go to my website at lmk88.com and just sign up for some weekly intuition tips. They're all there and they're free. Thanks for listening.